Hello there, everyone. Thank you for joining us today as we share again on purpose. Today we have another mighty man of God, Dorian Dwayne Henry Norton. He will be sharing on his purpose. Let's welcome him as he shares on his purpose.
Greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Dorian Dwayne Henry Norton. I would like to first give God thanks for giving me a purpose and for designing a purpose in my life. Secondly, I would also like to thank my dear cousin, Lois Francois, for speaking on this topic of purpose. I find that often people are just living their lives without a clear understanding as to why it is they are here or what it is they're supposed to do. And if you are living your life in such a manner, you are like a rudderless ship, not knowing where you're going without any real sense of direction. So purpose must be there. So thank you so much for doing this. And I really believe that these series of videos will really help and benefit people, not just in the kingdom of God, but over the cross, the reach of social media and whomever may come across these videos. My purpose in life, I have come to realize, is to be a servant in the kingdom of God. Now, that may not sound specific, but for me, it very much is specific. Just to be a servant in the Lord's kingdom is, I mean, just awesome to me. And that is my purpose, really. I'm reminded of the psalmist in Psalm 84, verse 10, that who says that I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. And being a servant in the kingdom of God is of such great importance and such great purpose in our world today, where there's so many who seem to be lacking direction and purpose in their lives. We as servants can help point them to their purpose and to their direction. And even in this forum as well, that can be effective. I came to realize this purpose, I want to say probably around the tender age of about 11 or 12. I remember well writing a letter to the Lord about just a letter of dedication of what I wanted to do with my life for God. Now, I had career aspirations and goals, for example, wanting to become a doctor, a surgeon. But I knew somewhere, somehow, even through my career, that I would want to serve the Lord in some fashion. And so I wrote a letter to God. And I used to sleep every night with that letter under my pillow, as if some sort of constant reminder that my purpose is really to give glory and honor to God through servanthood. And so after I was blessed with the Holy Ghost, I knew it was a call to service in the kingdom of God. I believe that when God saves us, he does not save us to be bench warmers, to use an athletic term. You know, I believe that every saint in the kingdom of God has a starting role and is in a starting position. There's no such thing as a bench warmer. And even if you're not necessarily playing a lead role, so to speak, we are always in preparation for where God is taking us, and that's towards our purpose. And so am I excited about my purpose? Absolutely. I currently serve in my role as being a servant. I currently serve as the youth minister at my local assembly, and I had an opportunity to speak to some of our young people at one of our recent church camps, and I spoke to them about the Word of God and how important it is in their lives. And young people came up to me afterwards, telling me how blessed they were by it and how impelled and challenged they were to become more connected to the Word of God. And so, of course, many of you might be familiar with the YouVersion app on your phones. I encouraged our young people to develop a daily habit of reading the Word of God and studying it for themselves and just falling in love with the Word. And so we connected across that medium. And I would see, young people who I serve, reading the Word of God, falling in love with the Word of God, highlighting notes, starting a new Bible plan. And they would come up to me and say, you really inspired me to go deeper in the Word of God. And, if there's nothing else that I ever do in this life, hearing that alone helps me to remember that I am fulfilling my purpose. So, in summary, purpose really is your life's mission. It's what gives your life meaning. It's what gives my life meaning. And so, when we are clearly aligned with what our purpose is, when we are focused on what our purpose is, we have a clear direction, we have a clear destiny. And once the destiny is very clearly defined, we are reaching to a clear destination. And so, on the converse, if you do not have a proper purpose fixed, you're not knowing where you're going. So I challenge everyone who may come across this video and these series of videos to find your purpose in this life, especially as it pertains to God and His kingdom and how you can reach others. Because if we all find our purpose, we will live meaningful lives and we will make a meaningful impact in the lives of others. I'm just so excited about my purpose and being a servant in the Lord's kingdom. And I just trust Him. Every day is a faith walk in purpose and by purpose. To watch him perform great deeds in my life.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Dorian Dwayne Norton, for sharing so much good food. I just pointed a few things that I think we should all go away with from what he shared with us. First, he said he gives God thanks for giving him a purpose. Then he said his purpose is to give glory to God through servanthood. How many times many people think they all want to be leaders or they want to be in the forefront. But yes, even in leadership, we are servants, and that should be our heart's desire. Another thing that I heard him say that I said, wow, I would love someone to say this about me at the end of the day, not because we think we're good in ourselves, but because we represent God. You inspire me to go deeper in the Word of God. When someone says that of us, we should know, we should just give God praise, as he said, give God all the glory because we are walking in our purpose. Our purpose is to bring men and women to God. Our purpose is to enhance the lives of others. And if someone could say to us, you have inspired me to go deeper in the things of God, then we know we are walking in our purpose, or at least in one of the purposes of our lives. Purpose, life's mission, is what gives you your life meaning. When you are clearly aligned with what your purpose is, you will have a clear destiny. And once that destiny is clearly defined, you are reaching to a clear destination. I like that. Again, when you are clearly aligned with what your purpose is, you have a clear destiny, and once that clear destiny is defined, or once that destiny is defined clearly, you are reaching to a clear destination. So all in all, we want to say thank you, Dwayne, for sharing with us. And I know that your word, what you have shared today about knowing your purpose and walking in your purpose, it has ministered to many. And I pray that those of us who yet do not know what our purpose is, that we will seek the Lord. And when the Lord speaks to us, we would not be afraid or we would not put it off, but we would step out and be obedient. Just that little thing that the Lord says to us, we step out. And as we step out, remember, the Lord is going to be with you every step of the way. And as you seek his wisdom and his guidance, you will be able to fulfill your purpose. So let's all seek to be purpose seekers and purpose to be driven by our purpose that God has for us. The main thing is knowing we are here. God has a purpose in our lives, and our goal, our mission should be to fulfill that purpose in our lives. Be blessed. Have a great day as you go today. Give someone a compliment. And again, we will have our music playing, but it would be another attachment under this video. You could just click on and listen to that song. It's a testimony, and it's powerful words that we confess even as we sing the song. It prepares us for whatever the enemy may bring our way, whatever curveball may come our way during the day to take us off guard. We would not worry. We would not walk in fear. Every impossible situation, we could smile at it knowing we serve a miracle-working God. Be blessed. Have a great day. See you tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. Take care. Bye.